Hello, I am Carson, the propulsion lead. Our project is to design, build, and fly an RC aircraft. We are sponsored by the American Institute of Aeronautics and Astronautics. The mentors for our project are Dr. Jagan Thanga and Dr. Sergey Sarayev. Our team members are Ben, Camden, Carson, Francisco, Sheldon, and Maddie.
There are three main missions. The first is completing three laps around the course in 5 minutes with our empty aircraft. The second is completing the same three laps in 5 minutes, but this time including a payload of our vaccine components. The final mission is to complete one lap with care packages on board, then land and deliver a package before taking off again, and repeating this for as many care packages that are on board. We have 10 minutes to do this mission.
The general shape of the aircraft was designed with efficiency in mind. Early on, it was decided that the fuselage has a streamlined shape. The final wing shape was chosen to be tapered, which bridges the aerodynamic performance of a rectangular and elliptical wing planform. The challenge was designing an aircraft that acts as a cargo plane and a STOL plane. The design parameters required our aircraft to take off within 25 feet. The massive airfoil trade study performed showed the best airfoil shape for the wings was the FX-63 because of its high lift performance with a Reynolds number range of 100 to 200,000 and manufacturing feasibility. The wing is mounted with an angle of incidence of 3 degrees angle of attack with respect to the fuselage reference line.
The main consideration for the internal structure was determining the amount of bulkheads necessary to fit the internal components as well as the payload for our missions while also maintaining structural integrity of the fuselage. There are four bulkheads strategically spaced out, made out of basswood and cut to shape of the fuselage. Three of the four bulkheads will connect to the wing mount as well. We cut the front of the nose off to mount the motor with a 3D printed part, which we used a high temperature thermoplastic for and added small holes for ventilation. The internal components consist of the motor, ESC, receiver, battery, servos, mounts / bulkheads, the release mechanism, and the payload for the mission. The syringes will be placed just behind the release mechanism under the wing. The release mechanism is placed at the center of gravity to keep that from shifting when the care package is dropped or when we are flying other missions. Payload. The payload release mechanism consists of two servos and four walls enclosing the care package. The two servos are located on the sides of the care package walls while their arms hold the care package in place over the bottom. It's lightweight and ergonomic.
The overarching and fundamental design for the propulsion system is characterized by a power subsystem and propeller combination which work in conjunction to produce thrust. The first consideration was to decide between an inrunner or outrunner motor. Inrunners are known to deliver high revolutions per minute, however generally supply low torque, whereas outrunners typically deliver low revolutions per minute and have higher torque. For slow-flying planes such as ours, a large propeller is preferred, as it is more suitable for producing higher thrust characteristics. The final component selected for the propulsion system was the propeller. We selected a 15x10 propeller, which has the maximum diameter allowed with our setup for clearance of the ground on takeoff and landing. The associated pitch was selected based on the theoretical analysis with a program called Prop Design, as well as experimental validation.
Set the limit. And then try to shut down, shut down. Okay, bring it down, bring it down, bring it down. No, grab it down. No, grab the cruiser and pull it down, Sergeant.
For the landing gear system, a tricycle configuration of fixed aluminum alloy landing gear was selected in order to offer the most level condition for our aircraft, and therefore cargo, great ground control, and quicker acceleration during takeoff due to thrust being perpendicular to the direction of travel while providing enough clearance for the propeller and payload hatch. In addition, this aluminum alloy landing gear provided safe takeoff and landing under our aircraft's parameters.
The aerodynamicist lead made it his top priority to make sure our plane design is stable in flight. The criteria for static stability is met for the longitudinal, directional, and roll of our aircraft. Our aircraft's aerodynamic performance was analyzed using computational fluid dynamics. Static flow simulations were performed to estimate the lift and drag coefficients of our aircraft at cruise condition. Transient flow simulations were used to investigate and model the flow separation on the wing of our aircraft. The flow simulation revealed that the flow will separate at about 13.5 degrees angle of attack. The flight envelope was mapped out using finite element analysis and computational fluid dynamics software.
Initial plans for construction were to build the fuselage and wing structure completely out of balsa wood and wrap it with monocoat, but instead we decided to use composite materials to save weight. We quickly got in contact with a professor who specializes in composites and learned how to make our fuselage. We used a CNC router to make a mold out of glued MDF boards and used a non-toxic system for sealing the boards with primer rather than Duratec. We did a lot of sanding and painting to perfect the molds before starting the actual composite process. Once it was perfected, we did multiple layers of mold release wax before spraying it with PVA, laying the carbon fiber and vacuum bagging the molds. After that, we popped the carbon out of the molds and started prepping the internal structure. We reinforced the carbon fiber fuselage with multiple layers of carbon specifically so that it could structurally handle the rigors of flight and landing. The wing and horizontal stabilizer were both made from styrofoam cells. There are 7 ribs that are made of balsa wood that were laser cut into the shape of the airfoil. These were glued to foam pieces that were hot wired to make the shape of the wing and horizontal stabilizer. After the foam components of the wing were all glued together, carbon fiber reinforcements were inlaid to add more structural rigidity to the wing. Then cutouts were made at the trailing edges of the wing for the control surfaces. Then monocoat was applied over the wing. The ailerons were made from pre-cut cambered balsa pieces. We wrapped the pieces in monocoat and attached them to the wing with tape, which makes a very simple, secure, and lightweight hinge. Then the servos were embedded and glued into the wing of the airplane, and the control surfaces were attached to the servo arms with a pushrod. The vertical and horizontal stabilizers were both designed in CAD and 3D printed as a single piece, which was simply glued to the aircraft. Servos for the empennage were mounted inside the fuselage and attached to the surfaces with pushrods.
Here is footage of our maiden flight. We are pleased to report that our aircraft surpassed our analytical performance expectations. The plane takes off with the required takeoff distance, carries our projected payload, and deploys the crate effortlessly. Furthermore, everyone was committed to their roles as subsystem leads and invested appropriate time into research and design. Consistent documentation and reporting of progress and analyses was fundamental to our success.